Hello and welcome to another episode of Inside the Ropes with Coach Mario. Coach Mario, owner and head coach of Warriors Pride Boxing Academy here in Miami, Florida. How are you guys doing this today? Beginning of the week, Monday. Great week. Looking forward to a great week ahead of us. I'm back in the saddle again, guys. I actually trained some of my fighters last week. I went for a fight camp with the guys on Saturday to the Tropical Park track. That was closed, but we went over to the hill and we ran some sprints. I didn't run. My guys ran. But anyway, guys, little by little, I continue to recover. Thank God. I have to thank him above everything else and everybody else that has said prayers for my recuperation. So far, so good. Still a little sore, not anywhere close to 100%, but hopefully 2-3 months down the line, I'll be okay. All right, guys, today we're gonna be very brief. I have to go back to the gym later on today. Basically, what I'm gonna talk about is the new member or the new champion of the 140-pound division, Isaac Pitbull Cruz, his victory, which I already predicted in this same channel a week or so ago, in which I said it wouldn't go past 8 rounds, that Pitbull was going to knock out Rolly Romero, and it turned out to be true. My other prediction didn't come to fruition. I was rooting for Fundora, but I was actually predicting that Tim Zhu was going to win by stoppage, and it did not go that way. I'm really glad because I like Fundora a lot. I enjoy his fights. He's a tall 6'6 fighter, tallest champion in that weight division, the history of that division. He did great. He fought his fight. He used that jab. Of course, that cut above the head of Tim Zhu actually evened things out. I'm looking forward to a rematch on that one, guys. But today what I'm going to talk about is the post-fight conference or post-fight interview and that Isaac Pitbull Cruz had right after the fight, right there in the ring. And he was asked several questions, obviously. He's another Mexican champion. He did great. However, one of the things I want to mention is I don't want to take anything away from Pitbull Cruz, but hey, guys, Rolly Romero was the weakest link there in that division, the weakest champ, if you want to call him a champ. I didn't ever consider him a champion. I don't know how he got that title. He really didn't deserve to be in that position. I believe that Ismael Barroso should have gotten that rematch with him, and if that would have happened, Barroso would have knocked him out. So, moving forward, like I was saying, Isaac Pitbull Cruz was interviewed right there in the ring after the fight, and he actually gave thanks to all his supporters. He's a humble guy, strong, little boxer who actually does look like a pit bull. And he mentioned that he wants to fight all the greats. He mentioned Devin Haney. He mentioned Teofimo Lopez. And he mentioned Tank Davis. But you know who didn't even mention? And it's funny how some of these guys have like amnesia. They forget there's another champion that nobody dares to mention. And that is El Orgullo Maternillo, Mr. Subriel Matias. He didn't mention him at all. And it's funny, I read today some of the news going out there, and Isaac Pitbull Cruz is trying to line up a fight against Ryan Garcia. right after Ryan Garcia fights Devin Haney. And guys, you know that I don't know how that's gonna work out, but I'm assuming that I believe it's the WBA champion for the WBA. Oh no, is it WBO or WBO? One of those. Anyway, I'm assuming that the organization should make Isaac Pitbull Cruz fight the mandatory. The mandatory in this case is Ismael Barroso, all right? That's the guy he's got to fight next. But Isaac Pitbull Cruz immediately, although he said in the post-fight conference afterwards that night, you know, where they actually interviewed him, they had questions from the media and whatnot, that one of the reporters there actually asked him, hey, a lot of people are mentioning you and Subriel Matias, what do you think of that fight? And he said, well, I'll fight anybody as long as, you know, my management team comes together with his management team, I'll fight him. But out of his own mouth, he has not mentioned Subriel Matias once, only that time when he answered that question from one particular reporter, all right? Who knows what the hell is going on? I commend that reporter is actually, you can tell he's not one of the groupies for some of these other guys, you know, a bought and paid for type of reporter. So that was a really good question. And I caught Pitbull a little out of surprise. He was surprised by that question, but he answered. He said, well, if it's in the cards and if it's, you know, something that my team can arrange, I will definitely fight anybody. But that's a generic way of answering questions. And a lot of fighters nowadays are using that same technique. But going back to Pitbull, the mandatory should be, he should fight Ismael Barroso next. That is what I am assuming. Let's see what the organization does in this case. If he forces if he forces Pitbull Cruz to defend his title against Ismael Barroso. But if that doesn't happen, we have Liam Paro and Subriel Matias fighting in June. All right. Pitbull just fought, so he's going to have to take some time off. I'm assuming he's taking at least three to 5 months off. So I can see either Pitbull Cruz fighting again in September, and I don't know if Subriel Matias is going to be able to fight by September, having a fight in June. He could probably do that, come around and fight a big fight right after that, September or October. I'm pretty sure they can negotiate something with the team of Pitbull Cruz. However, my opinion is that Pitbull Cruz is going to steer away from Subriel Matias as much as he can, just like the other champions in this weight division are avoiding Subriel Matias. Now, one of the good things that I see having a guy like Pitbull Cruz as one of the title holders for the 140-pound division is the following that he has. He's got that Mexican following, you know, in the States and obviously in his own country. So a fight between Isaac Pitbull Cruz and Subriel Matias would be another classic fight between a Puerto Rican and a Mexican, Mexico versus Puerto Rico. There's always great fights between both of these countries. There has been this kind of rivalry going back decades between these two countries, and it's always entertaining, guys. I don't know what the score is now, but I'm guess they're just about even as far as victories and whatnot for each country. But let me know, guys, what do you think? Subriel Matias versus Pitbull. I think Pitbull Cruz is tailor-made. Subriel Matias is a short little guy, 5'4". He can punch, and it looks like he's got power. However, you can't just think that he has power with a big, natural 140-pound guy when Rolly Romero has shown weakness, like a weak chin, and Subriel Matias is not that type of fighter. Rolly Romero, you know, he has fought, you know, sea level opposition all his life except with tank. So I don't credit Romero with a good resume in order to see what the standard is and how do you compare Rolly Romero with the other champions at 140. So it's like Pitbull Cruz at 5'4 versus Subriel Matias at 5'9, 5'10, I believe that's his height. Natural 140 pounder, strong guy that can has a granite chin that throws multiple combinations, short combinations. Eddie Ellis just mentioned, he's comparing him to Joe Lewis throwing a lot of short punch combinations. And you know that if you throw short punch combinations, you can actually throw more combos that way than if you throw straight shots, from regular distance, but or hooks for that matter, looping hooks. So what do you guys think? Do you think that Subriel Matias would how would he face against a tough opponent like Isaac Pitbull Cruz? In my opinion, Isaac Pitbull Cruz is the weak now. He's now the weakest link in that weight category. I think Subriel Matias would just destroy him inside of six, seven rounds tops. He is tailor-made for Subriel. I'm telling you, this is like a clash of two trucks, a little minivan and a Big Mac truck. So I see Subriel Matias having the edge on this one. First of all, he would have to get past Lee Amparo in June, and then later on, hopefully he can negotiate a fight with Isaac Pitbull Cruz. But guys, this would be interesting. Mexico versus Puerto Rico, I would love to see that fight. However, I think that all of those fans for Isaac Pitbull Cruz, and I really like the way he fights. I really enjoy his the way he is aggressive, and he continues to bring the fight over to his opponent. He's a typical Mexican fighter. However, against a monster like Subriel Matias, that style is not going to work, all right? So it doesn't matter what kind of style you have against Subriel Matias, you're going to suffer. And I don't know if Isaac Pitbull Cruz will go down to 135 again afterwards or will remain at 140. We'll see what time will tell, and we'll see what happens. But anyway, guys, this is a short video. Hope you enjoyed those fights. That Fundora Tim Zoo fight was, oh my God, that was bloody war, man. I'm looking forward to a rematch between those two guys. I don't think Errol Spence has no place in fighting, that doesn't deserve a fight with Sebastian Fundora. So I think a rematch in the States with Tim Zoo would be great. All right, guys. Well, anyway, thanks for tuning in again to another episode of Inside the Ropes with Coach Mario. Thank you very much for your support and your prayers. But this is all for now. So until next time, this is Coach Mario, owner and head coach of Warriors Pride Boxing Academy, saying hasta la vista. God bless you all and peace.